Matt Smith is Winona baseball through and through. He played for the Winona Windhawks in high school. He played for the Lee Jets in the summer. In amateur baseball, he played for his father, Al Smith, with the Winona Chiefs, and then he went on to play college ball for St. Mary's University. In his post-school life, he's been a head coach at Cotter and now at Winona Senior High, and it's not surprising where his love for baseball came from.
Even way before T-ball, you know, my dad and I, you know, it's a special bond that we share going way back, and, you know, throwing the wiffle balls around and just playing catch all the time. And then pickup games, and when we, you know, when my dad would be working during the day, you know, we'd play pickup games, and when he'd get done with work, he'd always show up on the field, and, you know, and at that point, when kids would get together, he would just pitch. And we would just play games, and you know, and he not only lit that fire of baseball in me, but he did the same in a lot of Winona kids.
It's like he was born with a ball in his hand, but he just, I could tell, again, he was one of these kids that was dedicated to it, dedicated to all the sports he played. He did play all three sports, but he did end up being more proficient in baseball. And he was a good student, and I figured that probably, in my mind, I pushed him more towards baseball because that's what he liked, and that's what, I couldn't go out and play football with him very well, and we shot buckets, yeah, we did that too, and we did a lot of the things like that, but I was always there for him when he'd want to play catch, or maybe hit him grounders, or just pitch batting practice to him too, and it wasn't just him. I pitched batting practice to probably 150 to 200 kids over my young career.
Playing through Winona High, he was president of the Booster Club back when I was going through here, and then when he took over the Chiefs, you know, that was real special too. You know, Dad was always there, and the cool thing is Dad is still always here. You know, all of our games, he sits up there in the right field corner in his car, and he's always here. I just treasure the time and the memories with him, but yeah, it was definitely my dad. You know, I had such good coaches as I moved through the programs too at the Park Rec League, and you know, I played out here for Jerry Raddatz, and you know, through the Legion, I had coaches like Jack Rader and Mark Patterson, and then played for Max Moloch out at St. Mary's. So I was taught very well.
One of Matt's fondest memories came from his amateur baseball days. He was part of the Winona Chiefs team that won a state championship in 1981.
That was fun. You know, again, it was interesting because, you know, the Chiefs back then, we really bonded. The 1981 team that when we did win the state tournament that year, there were only 13 guys on the team. But it's one of those things that is really so hard to explain because it was 13 families that were committed to the cause, and the cause was playing baseball, winning, going as far as we could. And the neat thing, you know, because at that age, we, you know, most of the kids were married, the guys on the team, we had, you know, families being started, young families, and anytime we'd call a practice, 13 guys were there. Anytime we'd decide, hey, let's have a team picnic, 13 guys were there, and you know, families were there, and it was just one of those things that you can't explain, because that entire season, especially down the stretch, and we had a great winning streak in there as we went through the state tournament anyway.
We had so many injuries early in the season that sometimes we were using second baseman to pitch, or the shortstop would pitch, or whatever, because we didn't have enough pitching. And we ended up at one time, we were 9 wins and 15 losses. And all of a sudden, everybody started getting healthy, and we played. We were so cohesive as one. The whole team played as one, and we ended up 30-15. So we won 21 straight games, going right through to the state tournament.
It was just a brotherhood, and it was one of those feelings where we knew if we were down by a run or two in the late innings, we weren't going to lose that game, and it was just that dependence that we had on one another. And it's truly a feeling that you may only get, many people may never have that opportunity in a lifetime, and it was just such a special thing. And then, you know, having my dad and my mom involved in there too just made it even more so. So it was a special thing. And then, you know, we came out the next year, did okay, you know, didn't repeat, and that feeling kind of went away. So, you know, I'll treasure those moments for the rest of my life.
Smith was All-State that season and hit a leadoff home run in a semifinal game against Columbia Heights to win the game 1-0 and send the Chiefs to the title game, which they won 3-0 over Minneapolis Lyconius. That was one highlight of a career that would continue as a coach.
Well, he was very versatile because he would pitch and he could play out, if outfield. He played shortstop. He was in at third on occasion. Second base was his best position. But he was probably say he was Mr. Utility, and every one of them he did well, of course. And that's the dad talking, I suppose. But he did well and very team oriented, completely team oriented. Give yourself up for the team. You know, it was just where I could see aspects of him coaching back in those days.
Smith would continue his baseball success as a coach. He always gives the credit back to his players, including his first coaching success at Cotter in 1984.
You know, that was a very special season too. You know, being second in the state, I don't get over to Cotter often, but when I do, it's always fun to see that banner hanging in the gym over there. When those kids went up to home plate and got the trophy, that meant more to me than any other awards that I had won, you know, as being a ball player anyway. That idea that, you know, I can transfer some things into kids, they can, you know, accept it, they can apply it to their lives, and they can be successful. So, yeah, I mean, but that's the way I view teaching, that's the way I view coaching, too.
After taking some time to work at his father's furniture store, Matt took up coaching again with Winona Senior High.
This opportunity opened up, you know, a little over 7 years ago, and this was really unexpected. I really didn't expect that I'd be in this position, and I'm thankful every day I walk out onto this beautiful ball field that I have the opportunity to do what I'm doing, because not everybody gets the opportunity to live, you know, their dreams, and right now I am doing exactly what I want to do, and I don't work at all. You know, I really don't. All I do is come out and hang out with kids all day long.
It's the teaching of the kids, the game, teaching the game. Not only on the field, but off the field, the things that going on, because life is a game.
So it's just been a love of baseball for a long, long time. You know, this job, it's like walking in the park. I love it. I wish I wasn't 55. I wish I was only 35 right now. But, you know, and there's an end in sight, but it's not for a while yet.